There's one thing we should all admit, and how do I say this without offending the entire human race? Modern technology has made all of us lazier. Admit it, it totally has. There are cars that will drive for us, apps that bring food to us, robots that sweep our floors. And now innovators have come up with an addition to the devices that make us lazier list. And this one lets you forego the mow. Here's Albert Lawrence to explain.
In America today, there are 95 million single-family homes, and many of them have their own yards, which is lovely, until you think about the upkeep. Watering, weeding, mowing, who has time for all that? Luckily, one man decided to take a pass on cutting the grass. I hit the road to Cedar City, Utah to meet Mike Green, an innovator who came up with an autonomous lawn sculpting robot called MowRo.
How did you get the idea for the MowRo?
It started as a young boy. I would mow all the neighbors' lawns, and summers in southern Utah are super hot. I thought, man, there's gotta be a better way to do this. And then later on in my life, my sister-in-law had an accident with a lawnmower, and I realized that lawnmowers really are causing a lot of injury. It's like 85,000 injuries a year in the US.
Mike's a creative inspiration from smaller robots designed to clean floors and beds.
If it's autonomous and it's out mowing the lawn, you can't have kids, animals, anything getting in the way, or it's going to be a huge problem. We wanted small blades. If you look at the design of them, they actually flip back. So if they hit something, it's not going to, you know, push through like you would with a traditional blade on a lawnmower.
So safety was one of your very first concerns.
Absolutely.
The smaller blades also cut the grass into a fine mulch, which eliminates any yard cleanup and helps keep the lawn fertilized.
There's all kinds of details with all the sensors, how they work, even just the programming. You know, a lawnmower needs to know where its boundary wire is, be able to sense it, and know how to create a pattern that will efficiently mow the entire lawn. It needs to know how to re-dock. That's a huge process, a lot of time and effort by a lot of people.
I visited Mike's home to see how his robotic mower operates.
So Mike, right here, sitting on your lawn, the MowRo almost looks like a race car.
Absolutely.
How long does it take for the MowRo to get your lawn to look the way that it does right now?
It'll charge and then mow for an hour, and then go back and charge, and it'll repeat that as many times as needed to cover the area you have.
The perimeter wire. So this is just literally like a thin wire that will go along the edge of your yard.
Yeah, it creates a magnetic field around the lawn that the mower can sense. It also uses that wire to find its home.
Mike started the battery-powered mower with a push of a button, and it was off and running.
And it's very quiet. I mean, can you hear it running?
No.
It's about the sound of an electronic toothbrush. In fact, the decibels of a regular mower is somewhere in between a freight train and a plane taking off.
Wow. Well, Mike, do you feel like you're disrupting the mowing careers of 15-year-olds everywhere now?
I think the 15-year-olds can mow a lot more lawns if they have a robot.
That's true.